Hey guys, I wanted to show you how I prep my Safer Solutions conductive paint by transferring it from the main jar into these little squeezy bottles. It really helps to keep them from drying out. It helps to keep the waste down because you're only dripping out as much as you need. It takes a little bit of extra prep in the beginning, but it's so worth it because I can make a 4-ounce jar of paint last at least a year and a half. I'll link all these products in the description. I've got my 4-ounce jar of Safer Solutions paint. I've got some 15 milliliter squeeze bottles with a little dropper tip. And I've got a 10 milliliter oral syringe, brand new and clean, so there's nothing contaminating my paint. And I've also got a plastic knife. Never use wood or anything organic with these. And that brings me to the next reason why I love using these little bottles, is that Safer Solutions is made with pure copper, so it is susceptible to being contaminated with anything organic. And that means that if you use a natural bristle brush and you keep using that brush, it's going to contaminate your paint. It's going to make it seize up. And when it seizes up, it becomes a lot like, almost like if you're melting chocolate and you added water to it and it gets all grainy and disgusting, that will happen to your paint. So you can try to be really careful with what kind of brushes you use and stuff like that. But with this method, you can use any brush you want because you're never putting it in contact with the jar of paint. All right, so now I've got my 6 bottles here. I'm actually going to end up with 7 in the end because of the way I thinned it. But I've got my little syringe. And each one of these has its own little plug that works perfectly to drip out just the right amount of paint. So I'm going to shake up my paint. It comes with some electrical tape around it when you first get it. And a little glass marble in there to help shake it up. But I'm also not only going to shake it, but I'm also going to stir it with this knife very well. So just to get all the sides scraped and everything. And oh my God, look when you open this. Ah, gorgeous. Gorgeous, so creamy and beautifully metallic. Oh my God, I love it. So I'm just going to stir the hell out of this and scrape the edge of the knife and scrape the edge of everything. And Safer Solutions paint, the way it comes naturally, is just a little bit too thick for my liking. It really doesn't need to be this thick for application. In fact, I find it's a lot better if you just thin it down a little bit. So that's what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be using some distilled water to thin this down. And I'm going to add that water to each little bottle before I add the paint. So I like to have about a 1-to-7 ratio, 1 part water, 7 parts paint. And I'm going to use my oral syringe to just quickly fill up one little part, probably about 1/4 inch to the bottom of each bottle before I begin adding the paint. And I'm going to try to be really careful here not to get paint everywhere. It can be pretty messy, so I'm just going to stick just a little bit in and try to keep that tip as clean as possible. And then I'm just going to fill it up the rest of the way, leaving a little bit of room so there's some ability to shake it up, you know, blend it up afterward. And then I'm just going to put the little fitted cap in that allows it to have a little dropper on it. These white cap ones have a little bit of a larger opening, whereas the black cap ones are smaller and tend to get a little more clogged. I like both of them for different reasons, but these white ones are what I had on hand, so that's what I'm showing you. But the black ones are also on my Amazon list. So just fit that right in there and then give it a shake. And if you plan on using Safer Solutions with an airbrush where you really want it to be super, super thin, this is a great way to keep a little bottle of pre-thinned Safer Solutions for use in your airbrush. You can really get away with thinning it way, way, way down when you use an airbrush. Probably even like a 50-50 ratio or even more water. But I find that the more water you use to thin it down, the longer it takes for it to dry. So when you airbrush, let it dry, resist the urge to touch it for quite a while. Now, when I got to the bottom of the jar, I realized that there was enough paint left over for a whole nother little bottle. And that's with the 1-to-7, approximately 1-to-7, I eyeball it now, ratio of distilled water to paint. So about, 1/4 inch, maybe a little bit less along the bottom initially of water, and then fill it up to the top with the Safer Solutions paint. And then I like to wrap the base of the cap with some electrical tape just to make sure no air is getting in there, because these are actually going to last so long that they're going to be sitting quite a while before we get to the next one. The reason I like this size bottle is it's the perfect size that you've used it up by the time it just starts to get a little thick from the air building up in there as it gets used up. So the smaller the bottle, the less time it has air sitting on top of it before your next bottle gets started. Anyway, I hope you found this helpful, and thank you so much for watching.